I'm talking with farmers about diseases that are present in the crop at the moment, and which of those diseases might impact yield and or grain quality. A lot of farmers are asking about Goss's wilt. Goss's wilt was a severe problem across the state last year. And this year we have seen some Goss's wilt, but the hot, dry conditions have definitely kept it at bay. It is out there if you planted a susceptible hybrid onto a field that had Goss's wilt. Is it something I need to worry about next year? And of course it is. And then the other big question at the moment is the hot, dry conditions, and that would be Aspergillus ear rot. And associated with Aspergillus ear rot is aflatoxin. And that's a toxin that, if it gets into the feed, is very dangerous for livestock and pets and also humans. But when you're out in the field looking for Aspergillus ear rot, what you should be doing is peeling back the husks and then just looking at the tips of the ears. And what you're going to look for is this olive green powdery mold. It's very powdery. Sometimes when you pull back the husks, you'll just see a cloud of dust, and that dust is the spores being produced from that. But this is the fungus, okay? And the fungus is called Aspergillus flavus. The disease is called Aspergillus ear rot. And if you see signs of this ear rot, so if you see this ear rot in your corn, it means that your corn could be at risk for aflatoxin. If you do see this in the field, the first thing you should do, probably before you've even walked out of that field, is call your insurance adjuster so that they can come, have a look at the corn, and they can advise you what to do next. Once you've harvested the corn from this field and put it in the bin, it's no longer covered by insurance, so it still needs to be in the field. One of the things that we know is that high temperatures, and especially warm nights when temperatures are above 70 Fahrenheit, those will favor the production of aflatoxin by this fungus. So just because you have the ear rot doesn't necessarily mean you have the aflatoxin. If we have cool conditions like we did a couple of weeks ago with those nighttime temperatures going down into the 50s, then aflatoxin will probably not be a problem. But if we have, like we're having right now at the Farm Progress Show, the temperatures up into the 90s, those warm nights, that's increasing our risk of aflatoxin. So our advice is to harvest that corn as quickly as possible and to dry it down quickly. If you dry it and cool it quickly, it will prevent the fungus from growing. If the fungus is not growing, it can't produce the aflatoxin. Once you've got the aflatoxin in the grain, there's nothing you can do about it. And so the FDA has set an action level of 20 parts per billion. If grain from your field comes back as over 20 parts per billion, then that makes it difficult to sell that grain. Now, there are certain livestock that you can feed that grain to. For example, beef cattle, you can feed up to 300 parts per billion. So you could blend aflatoxin contaminated grain with other feedstuffs just to bring that level down. But with some livestock, for example, dairy, I mean, the limit there is very, very low, 0.5 parts per billion. If the level of aflatoxin in the grain is extremely high, you know, a few hundred parts per billion, it might end up that you need to bury that grain, burn it, and somehow destroy the grain. So it means knowing what disease is in your field, talking with your seed company representative, making sure you're on the same page, choosing the right hybrid for the right field.